Well, I'd like to start by saying, they talked about how I didn't mention the fact that children are not learning in Zooms. Well, let's be honest, children don't pay attention anyways, you know? But hey, they go to the Zooms, they see the lion, or the tiger, or the bear, and they get inspired. They're like, I want to look after that animal someday. I want to be a zookeeper. I want to help save the wild. And that's what it's all about, really. And then, sure, I didn't talk about anything else but zoocosis, but the diseases that these animals would carry will exist in the wild, too. But zoos can provide medicine to cure these. You know, if in the wild, they're on their own. They either die or they get eaten or they muddle through it. And that's not a good thing. And then, again, zoos killing animals because they are not the fittest. This goes back to Darwinism, right? And predators would get the slowest of anything anyway. So, again, they have a higher success rate in the zoos of living. But let me go back to conservation. It took the entire history of humankind for the population to reach 1 billion around 1810. By 1930, this doubled to 2 billion people. Today, there are over 6 billion people. As the population continues to grow, so does the need for space and housing and food. And where do we get that? We take away from the animals. And then, there were only 22 California condors left in the wild by the late 1980s. But the San Diego Zoo used condor hand puppets to feed baby birds, and now more than 200 fly free. Well, that's a lot of condors. And the Phoenix Zoo helped bring the Arabian oryx back. Extinct in the wild in 1972, there are more than 1,000 roaming freely. And critically endangered by the loss of their Brazilian rainforest habitat, the golden lion tamarin status has been improved by captive breeding at DC's National Zoo. And there are only 45 Amur leopards remaining in the wild, but there are 220 in breeding programs in zoos around the world, with a reintroduction scheme currently in the planning stages. So these things are well on their way to recovery. And Colorado's Cheyenne Mountain Zoo has used the artificial insemination to breed and release over 200 black-footed ferrets, which were mostly extinct in the wild by 1980. And the San Diego Zoo just opened the Conservation and Research for Endangered Species Center. This $22 million center gives scientists cutting-edge instruments and plenty of room to do their work. And lastly, I'd like to point out that it's not just humans that can take away from other animals. When non-native plants or animals are introduced into an area, they may disturb the natural balance of the ecosystem. Introduced species may overpopulate the area, compete for food, carry diseases for which native species may have no immunity, drive out other species, and cause numerous other problems. So as you can see, yes, zoos can have some problems, but everything has its problems. The important part is zoos are doing their part to conserve, educate, and lend their part to research. Thank you.